Well, it is 8 o'clock and we are standing by for a Queensland police update on that sole survivor of a triple fatal crash on the Bruce Highway being charged with three counts of murder.
Today, Queensland reporter Andrea Crothers has been following this story since it happened and joins us live now. Andrea, the accused remains in hospital this morning.
Yeah, guys, that person is 25-year-old Rafferty Rolfe. I'm told he was unable to appear in court yesterday due to his injuries, and it's likely to be a similar scenario today. But, of course, today, waking up with fresh charges, three murder charges. Now, police will allege that Mr. Rolfe first stole a Isuzu before then attempting to ram a ute, before that ute then collided with another vehicle. Three people dead. Those being Jessica Townley, an alpaca farmer, Gypsy Satterley, Mr. Rolfe's ex-partner, a young mother, as well as 65-year-old Terry Bishop, a good Samaritan who was on his way driving from Mackay to southeast Queensland for a wedding when he stopped to pick her up to try and help. Now, Mr. Rolfe himself, he sustained head injuries in that crash and was taken to hospital, where he has been ever since. But he is due to appear in court today, and as you said, we are standing by for that police presser expected in just moments.
All right, Andrea, thank you. A two-year-old boy has been reunited with his parents after a thief jumped into the family car and sped off while the toddler was still inside. Today, reporter Isabella Stashkovsky is in Melbourne with the story for us. Isabella, the hunt is on this morning for the driver.
Sarah, that driver has been on the run since late yesterday following that terrifying ordeal for that family. That little boy was missing for more than an hour, then later found 16 kilometres away from where he was last seen, just wandering the aisles of a Woolies in the Fern Tree Gully. It was a passerby, a stranger, who saw him and thought that something was amiss and then alerted authorities. His father, earlier that day in Dandenong on Cleland Street, had been involved in a bingle, stepped out of the car just momentarily to speak with the other driver, and then that opportunistic thief has jumped inside the vehicle driving away. That family car, a black Kia Carnival, it is still missing as well. We'll bring up the number plates now. They are 1WU5QT, but a terrifying ordeal for that family, a very emotional reunion as well. That father was inconsolable, according to police, when he first spoke to them. Thankfully, that little boy is waking up this morning back safe and sound in his family home, but police this morning, I've just spoken with them, are still searching for that man and that vehicle.
All right, thank you.
Imagine if someone stole your car with your two-year-old in it.
Terrifying. Oh.
Well, evacuation orders have been issued across more Greek islands this morning as the country faces its biggest fire emergency. As firefighters battle to contain spreading flames, thousands have spent the night waiting on the airport floor, desperate to board repatriation flights. Locals are being told there will be another three difficult days ahead.
It was just, it's hard to explain, you know, when you're in that kind of emergency and you've got your children with you, it's like, it's full panic. So I just said to the kids, get away from anything flammable.
Hell on earth. Never thought I'd be caught up in something like that. There's someone's going to end up dying out there, seriously.
The ongoing fallout from the Robodebt scandal has seen a senior public servant quit amid heavy criticism over their role. Let's go to Maggie Rayworth with the details now. Maggie, good morning. The Royal Commission has turned up the heat.
It certainly has, Brooke. Pressure is mounting on the former Prime Minister, Scott Morrison, to quit Parliament after the scathing report was released. The report accused Morrison of misleading Cabinet over the unlawful Robodebt scheme. Scott Morrison was spotted for the first time since returning from his European holiday. It's the first time the former Prime Minister has been seen since the Royal Commission was handed down.
How was your holiday?
You're on my property.
Will you be stepping down from Parliament?
Now, that was just hours after confirmation senior public servant Catherine Campbell quit her $900,000-a-year top defence job. Catherine Campbell's resignation comes after the Royal Commission into the illegal Robodebt scheme her department oversaw. The Royal Commission found Ms Campbell did not act when exposed to the wrongdoings. Now, she was suspended from her advisory role at the Department of Defence just 3 days after Commissioner Catherine Holmes tabled the report. Brooke?
OK, thanks, Maggie. Family and friends of the victims of the horror New South Wales Hunter Valley wedding bus crash are this morning urging the federal government to improve safety in the bus industry across the nation. Among them, Adam Bray, whose son Zach was among the 10 killed in the disastrous rollover a little over a month ago. Adam now campaigning for change, he spoke to Today on Nine a short time ago.
You wouldn't fly on a plane with no safety checks.
Mm.
Yeah? You wouldn't fly on a plane with only one pilot who's qualified for driving a truck. Bus truck drivers, that's the license. 21-year-old can drive that. So why do you think you're safe on a bus? You're not until big changes are made.
Federal Roads Minister Catherine King says she's asked her department to give advice on the proposal.
Sport, and the Roosters' late final surge has received a boost with young halfback Sam Walker set to return within the next couple of weeks. The 21-year-old went up to Townsville to meet with an ACL specialist after tearing a ligament 3 months ago. Walker passing a series of fitness tests, and he'll now make his way back to the NRL via the New South Wales Cup. St Kilda's Max King is making a speedy recovery from a shoulder injury that initially ruled him out of the AFL season. Coach Ross Lyon revealing the Saints spearhead could be back as early as next week for an important clash with Carlton. King had a shoulder reco in the off-season and re-injured that same shoulder against Melbourne 2 weeks ago. Carlton, of course, playing Collingwood on Friday. It's going to be massive.
It's going to be a big one.
Hey.
Everybody.
Every weekend's a big one.
I know. Carlton and Collingwood.
It'll be huge. Like they did against Port Adelaide.
All right, let's get your weather now with Tim, who joins us from magnificent Fiji dining. Delicious.
Oh, Timmy.
I do, guys. Good morning. I found Erica and Wayne, who just so happened to be from the Gold Coast. Like, they've left paradise in Australia and come here to Fiji and found paradise. Isn't it beautiful? We're just easing in for some cocktails and a lazy morning by the pool. We'll have a chat to them in just a second. But first, let's take a look at your forecast. Right across Australia, good morning to you, Cairns. Heading today for a top of 25 degrees, looking mostly fine and sunny. Brisbane for you, mostly sunny, a top of 22 degrees. Sydney, good morning, mostly sunny and 18 degrees on the way. Canberra, some morning frost to kickstart the day. Mostly sunny though and 16 degrees ahead. Melbourne, cloudy and 15. Hobart, partly cloudy, 15 for you. Adelaide, partly cloudy, 16. Perth, showers around today and a top of 18 degrees. Alice Springs, sunny and 19. And Darwin for you, sunshine and a top of 28 degrees. Well, this morning we are at Oceanside, which is Oceanside, as you can see by the view behind me, obviously. Fish Bar is where we are. This is beautiful. So Marriott has done a bit of a collaboration with our very own Matt Moran. These are some of the featured dishes. This is the snapper ceviche. We up for a bit of snapper ceviche for breakfast, Wayno?
I had breakfast at All You Can Eat buffet.
Well, my friend, All You Can Eat, snapper ceviche right here, right now. As we look out to the breakers off the reef, as you can see here, tell us about your experience so far, lazing by the pool, enjoying yourself. It's a tough life, isn't it, Wayne?
Yeah, we've been here for 3 or 4 days now, and we've just come to the pool. We're going on our 3 expeditions later on in the week, but you really don't have to go anywhere. It's all here.
Yeah.
Just look out the ocean. You can see the surf out there. I've seen the surfers go out there and the private boats going out there to do the surfing. You've seen them come back.
I know.
It's beautiful.
What a way to live. Erica, you've never looked so relaxed.
I enjoy all the cocktails here. They come here at
me
nine
too.
In the...
This is why we're going to be friends from now on. Yeah, loving it. What's been the highlight for you, just lazing by the pool and...
Just lazing by the pool, and the people, they're very friendly.
Aren't they?
The Fijians.
I know, the happiness. Yeah. It's just everywhere. It's spread. It's infectious with their big smiles. Well, thank you both for letting me crash our little dining experience and the cocktails here this morning at Fish Bar Oceanside, which is where we are, the Fiji Marriott Resort here in Momi Bay. As you can see, everyone's enjoying the cocktails. What time of the day is it? Must be 5 o'clock somewhere, guys. We're going to get stuck into that. And I did promise I would show you the overwater bungalows in the lagoon. I will take you back there, Carl, Sarah. I know you're very keen to see that here at Momi Bay. We'll see you in half an hour. Bye.
Also, we're very keen on seeing the yoga instructor again.
Yes.
Just quietly. Give the nation what they want, Timmy.
Done. Missy is coming for you.
All right. Done. Excellent.